Brian's dad and his family came to this area from Coronation, Alberta.
This land in Westeros has been in Verna and Brian Phippen's family for decades.
Initially, when Brian's parents were farming, they had a small dairy.
But there's more here than sweeping landscapes and cows that pasture. Pump jacks dot the property, and 17 pipelines run through it. Oil and gas has been here almost as long as the Phippen family themselves. But there have been blowouts, corrosion, and spills over the years.
As things happen more and more and more, I begin to hate it. I begin to hate the petroleum industry.
Two inactive wells sit on their land. This stick represents where one still is underground. They've stopped producing, but they have not been cleaned up yet. It's a problem that's steadily growing. There are now close to 100,000 inactive wells in Alberta, up more than 10% from last year, and a jump of more than 25% from just 4 years ago. And the COVID-19 pandemic may be making things worse. Global News obtained this presentation to the AER board through a Freedom of Information request, and it is blunt. It notes many operators are shutting down production. Some will likely not ever be able to restart, and some are not following proper suspension and decommissioning procedures.
We're always worried about bigger issues, leaks, and general environmental contamination.
The AER points to a dashboard that shows recently 86 companies failed to pay required levies, some shut down, and others were ordered to clean up. The AER also says it has tools to bring companies back into compliance. The Orphan Well Association is funded by industry and is supposed to look after wells left behind. Governments have also chipped in.
We do see that the funding that's come from the provincial and federal government has helped expedite the work that we're doing. And we do feel like we're well situated to deal with this issue, at least here for the short term.
But experts say if more companies go under than the association can deal with,
the public will have to pony up, or the levy on continuing oil and gas producers would have to be dramatically increased.
We're very near that worst case scenario. I think the tip of the iceberg in terms of massive liabilities that are going to be dumped onto the public purse.
The problem is not going away anytime soon. More than 6,600 wells are forecast to become inactive in the coming year. Industry organizations say they are not aware of their members walking away during the pandemic.
I don't think it represents the majority of the industry by any sense.
You get into this business knowing exactly what those obligations are. We do have a few defaulting companies that are unable to discharge those.
Harold says defaulting companies are in the minority and there are safety nets for them. As for the Phippen family, they aren't interested in letting oil and gas come on their land anymore.
Who's going to look after us? Nobody is. Nobody's looking after us.
Julia Wong, Global News.